Hi and welcome to another episode of Singing Teacher Reacts. My name is Peter Vox and I am the director and principal teacher of Vox Singing Academy here in beautiful Melbourne, Australia, and I have been since 1993. If we could help you or someone that you know with their singing, we'd be absolutely honored. We have six studios here in beautiful Melbourne, Australia. We also do online singing lessons 7 days a week worldwide. We also do have the ultimate online singing course if you're not wanting face-to-face singing lessons, so please check out the links below for more info. You like this channel, give us a thumbs up, click subscribe to keep up with a lot more videos. We're not just a reaction channel, we also have podcasts, tips and hints regarding the voice. We also do have another YouTube channel which is solely dedicated to free singing tuition. It's got hundreds of videos on it. It's called The 5 Minute Singer. Check it out if you want singing tips and hints on every single known subject. There are hundreds of videos on there. Without any further ado, quite a few people have wanted me to react to Chris Cornell. Now, Chris Cornell has a very long, a very long and colourful and very different career. He started off in Soundgarden, which were the first grunge band. They started grunge. They released the Bad Motorfinger album in 1989 before grunge really broke. I think grunge really broke in 90. That's when I think it really broke, but they were the pioneers and the founders of grunge, I really think. That Bad Motorfinger album, quote me if I'm wrong, it might have even come out earlier than that, but I'm sure that it came out in 1989, that album. And it's just an exceptional, probably one of the best grunge albums of all time, that particular album. And his voice on that, you want someone who's got an absolutely exceptional voice, who was pushing the boundaries of what their voice could do, check out that album. Check out Jesus Christ Pose and Slaves and Bulldozers and some different songs on that album. It's just it was mind-blowing. My jaw just dropped when I heard that album. But I'm not going to do a song off that, because he's more, and later on in his career, he was more well-known. He went and joined that band that just slips my mind now, which has got Rage Against the Machine in it, Audioslave. He went and joined Audioslave and had success with them. He released a bunch of solo albums, and he went back to Soundgarden at the end, and then he did forge himself as a great solo artist as well too, and really did a lot of solo shows, and I think that was really his passion, was his solo shows. And this is an acoustic version of a Prince song, Nothing Compares to You, which was actually made famous by Sinead O'Connor. And I haven't heard this song. I've had a few people wanting me to do a react videos to Chris Cornell, and I just typed in Chris Cornell, and this was the first video. Don't know when it was done, don't know what year, but it's obviously later in his career. And never heard it, but I am very, very much interested, because this is an amazing song. Prince's version is an amazing song. Sinead O'Connor's version is amazing, and I'm sure this is going to be an amazing vocal version as well too, from one of the great rock, folk, grunge vocalists of all time, the late great Mr. Chris Cornell. Let's get stuck into it.
It's been 7 hours and 15 days since you took your love away. I go out all night and sleep all day since you took your love away. nothing can take away these blues. There's nothing compared, nothing compared to you. It's been so lonely without you. Can't stop these lonely tears from falling. Tell me, where did I go wrong? I could put my arms around any girl I choose, but it just reminds me.
Fantastic. That was really moving. I was really moved with that version there. An amazing version, an amazing singer, an amazing songwriter, and I don't know about a person, I've never met him, but I'm sure that he was. Now his vocal style probably goes a little bit against some of the techniques that I would be teaching and in my classes. One is that he doesn't use his mouth a lot. It's been 7 hours. So he keeps it sort of like this. I think that you get a better sound when you start to, it's been 7 hours, and use your mouth a little bit more. But that's really his thing that he's done. Besides when he starts to get up into the middle part or higher part of his range, towards the end of the song, he was smiling on that nothing at the end there. My thing, I would have said, hey Chris, use your mouth a little bit more. So one, we can understand you a little bit more, and your pronunciation, your articulation, and diction is better. But so I understood most of what was being said then. I thought it was very, very good. I was surprised when he started, he had his legs crossed, and he was kind of a little bit sort of hunched over when he first started. But then about halfway through the performance, when he had to sing a little bit higher, he did actually uncross his legs, and he nearly elongated himself. He made himself kind of straight. He kind of tilts his head a little bit to one side when he's singing as well. So I like to keep the head straight, but still very good. You can see he's right here. His posture's quite good. His spine is very elongated. He's got a great voice. He was sort of hitting some high notes here and there just to show his voice off. And the song emotionally built up. He built the volume up through the song and started to hit bigger notes and was singing louder. He started off singing in the pocket to start with, but then he was singing louder towards the end. And yeah, look, I thought it was a very moving song, and I thought that the version that he did was great. As I said, I've never heard this version, and as I said, I just put in Chris Cornell. This is the first song that came up, and don't know what year it was recorded, but it was an absolutely moving song and great control. A beautiful tone, and I would have given Chris Cornell here, I would have given him 9 out of 10. The only thing that I was faulting is that I just would have liked his mouth to work a little bit better in some of the lower things. It's a bit like that, but his pitch was exceptional. His posture was really good once he sort of got halfway through the song and he thought, okay, let's uncross the legs, let's get it a bit straighter. Sounded absolutely fantastic. Obviously running, it looks like he's just using a standard mic, but it sounded like he was being nearly recorded to a condenser mic. Sounded really good. His voice is really crisp and clear through this recording. It's a great recording. And yeah, dearly missed. His music still lives on, but dearly missed as a person. It was really nice to hear this song. If you like this reaction, please click like and subscribe. Share it with your friends. If you want me to react to a song, please put it in the comments below with the link. I have got a backlog of about 100 other songs, but I will get through as many of them as I possibly can. If not, just drop by and say hello. Tell me where you're from. Put a little flag. It's really great keeping up with all of the people internationally here. I've traveled to more than 70 countries. I'd like to travel to a lot more in the future, but because we've been in lockdown, we can't do that at the moment. But it's really great to interact with all of these people from all around the world. And thank you so much for watching. It's a great community. Please keep your comments polite and nice. If we could help you or someone that you know with their singing, please check out the links below. We have 6 studios here in Melbourne. We give online singing lessons worldwide, and we also have the ultimate online singing course. If you are a little bit apprehensive to have face-to-face singing lessons, check that out. High-quality singing lessons stream to you anywhere, anytime. The most important thing is, please live with passion. Be grateful for every day, because you never know when it's going to be your last. And be nice to each other. Enjoy your music and enjoy your singing. Until the next React video, be good to everyone. Peace and love.